Once upon a time, in a lonely farm, lived a cat named Banjo, and his two sisters, Emily and Jean.
Yes.
Okay, Emily, you're first.
One day, their TV set broke while watching cartoons, and had to move out to find a new set.
Wow, that is not good.
Little did Banjo know about the events that were bound to happen.
Well, there's a cool play place I made for kittens like you.
I've always wanted to picture what the place looks like.
Oh, it's gonna be nice. You'll love it.
That big brown cat is none other than Rocco.
Based on the classic short film by Don Bluth, comes a story of courage, romance, and survival.
I can't find any switches.
Fred Bear Studios presents a Pip Pip Enterprises production. Banjo the Woodpile Cat.
You have exactly 1 minute to fetch me a switch.
Mommy, Banjo's chasing chickens again.
Banjo dear, you know Dad doesn't like having you chase chickens. That's called disturbing them. So, would you do me a favor and leave them alone?
Yes, Mom.
Good. That's more like it.
I wonder if there's anything I can do. I got it. Hey Emily, Jean, do you two want to play tag?
Yes.
Okay, Emily, you're first. You're it.
Now you're it.
Do you want to go next, Jean?
Sure.
You're it.
Gotcha. Now you're it.
I'm gonna get you.
Banjo. Are you alright? Speak to us. Oh dear. Are you okay, Banjo?
I'm alright. Can you get me out? Aw, thank you.
No problem.
What's going on out here? I heard a crash and then a splash.
Nothing. We were just playing tag with Banjo and he went too fast and crashed through a fence and landed in a pond. We went over to get him out.
Alright, I was making sure Banjo wasn't doing anything to the chickens.
Well, Banjo, what do you think we could do next?
Let me think. Oh, I know.
What is it?
After I landed in the water during the game of tag, I noticed that there's some rocks on the pond. How about we jump across them?
I think that might be a good idea. Just make sure you don't fall in again.
Alright. Here goes nothing. Follow me. I just counted these rocks, and there's like 10.
Yeah. So, who wants to go first?
I'll go. Last one across is a rotten egg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Oh no. Banjo, you didn't notice that you jumped on a lily pad. Don't worry. We'll get you out.
I'm so cold.
The water must have been cold when you fell in. Yeah, we should get you inside and warm up. Also, I think the sun is setting. We should go now.
Okay, right now, we're eating dinner and watching TV. Can you get the light, Jean?
Yes, Daddy.
Hi, Dad.
What are you doing?
Making sure those chickens don't pester me.
You should look at the TV right now. This cartoon is pretty funny.
Hey, you.
Banjo, how many times do I have to say this? Do not upset them.
Sorry.
Now let's look at the TV.
I didn't do it.
Of course, you didn't do it, you silly. Ugh.
I told you that was a cheap set.
It's not a cheap set, it's a stolen set. Emily, can you get the other light?
Yes, Daddy.
Wow, that is not good.
Well, how are we gonna see our cartoons now?
We might have to move out for a while until a new set comes in.
Where should we go? Yeah, where to?
I know. I think we should head on down to Salt Lake City. Did you hear that, Banjo?
What is it, Dad?
We're gonna go to Salt Lake City.
Wait, really?
Yup. First thing tomorrow. Ah. Now, we better get to bed. It's getting laid out.
What's wrong, Banjo?
I can't sleep.
How come?
I had a bad dream. It was about a creepy bulldog chasing me.
It's okay. Mommy will protect you. I know just the way to calm you down so you can get a peaceful sleep.
Once there was a way to get back homeward, once there was a way to get back home. Sleep, pretty darling, do not cry, and I will sing a lullaby. Once there was a way to get back homeward. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep, pretty darling, do not cry, and I will see.
Good night, Banjo. Rise and shine, my kittens.
We've got a big day ahead of us.
Oh boy, going to Salt Lake City.
Yup. Now we better get going.
Rise and shine, crazy.
Good morning, Tina.
You might as well go get dressed.
Good idea. I choose purple.
Crazy, have you finished yet?
Yeah. I'll be right out.
Wow, you look very nice.
Thank you, Tina.
We've got some stuff to do.
Yeah.
This looks good.
Yep. Very fitting.
Let's go inside.
Just don't cause any trouble in there.
Crazy legs?
Banjo? Oh, my kitty. What's up? Ha 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 ha. Hey there, little one. You okay?
I'm doing great.
What brings you here to my place?
Well, we just came from Payson, and we had some blow up with the TV.
Whoa, that's not good.
Yeah, I didn't do it.
I believe you on this one.
By the way, is there anything you want to show me?
Actually, there is.
Really? What is it?
Well, there's a cool play place I made for kittens like you. By the way, this is my good friend, Tina.
Hey Banjo. My name's Tina.
It's so good to meet you. Anyways, what is this play place you want to show me?
Well, follow me and I'll show you.
Alright. Let me go tell my parents first before going off.
Go ahead. I'll wait for you.
Mom, Dad?
What is it, Banjo dear?
There's a cool play place I'm going to check out.
Wow, that's really cool. Just don't do anything stupid there, alright?
Yes, Dad.
Have fun.
Crazy legs, they said I can go.
Awesome. Well then, let's boogie.
Right behind you.
Don't forget me.
Of course.
I've always wanted to picture what the place looks like.
Oh, it's gonna be nice. You'll love it.
Wait a minute, who's that white kitten?
Banjo? You okay there, buddy?
What? That kitten looks so hot.
Oh, my gosh. She's so beautiful.
Hey there. What's your name?
My name is Banjo. That cat with the purple scarf is Crazy Legs, and that white mousey is on top of his hat is Tina.
Wow. My name's Brinley.
It's so good to meet you, Brinley. My, that white fur you have is pure white as the snow.
Thanks. Where are you guys heading off to?
Well, me, Crazy Legs, and Tina are heading to a really fun play place for kittens.
Wow. That must be so cool. Mind if I come too?
Sure.
Let's go.
So Banjo, where have you come from?
I've come from the Woodpile Farm in Payson.
Wow. I love that place. I came all the way from Frisco. My, I just love to look at the mountains there.
Same here. I always like to view the West Mountains from my home, too.
That's cool. How come you've came down to Salt Lake City?
Well, we were watching a cartoon on TV. It was pretty funny, but the television set blew up. Must have been from a short outer malfunction.
Oh goodness. That's not good. Were you okay?
Yeah. I didn't even do it, and my parents believed me. Would they believe you?
Maybe or maybe not, it all depends.
Yeah, I think so too.
Well, here it is. This is the play place I made. Kitty Cat Play.
Whoa. This place is amazing.
I definitely agree with you.
Hey, is that my best friend over there?
Tundra.
Brinley.
Banjo, this is my closest and best friend, Tundra.
Hi. My name's Tundra. What's yours?
My name's Banjo, and this is Crazy Legs. And that little white mouse on top of him is Tina.
Hey there, Tundra.
My, you are looking pretty there today.
Aw, thank you, Tina.
So Banjo, what do you want to do first?
Oh, I want to go play on those slides.
Alright, let's go.
I bet you can't catch me.
Oh, I'm gonna get you. Ha. Now you're it. Try to get me now.
Oh, I'll try to get you. Who's that?
I don't know.
You don't want to go near that big cat.
Yeah. He's pretty scary if you ask me.
Who is that scary, big brown cat?
That big brown cat is none other than Rocco.
He really likes to crack that whip to see who's trying to hide.
By the way, what's your names? My name's Brinley.
I'm Banjo.
And I'm Tundra.
My name's Darlene.
And I'm Danio.
Rocco doesn't really hit kittens with that whip, does he?
Nope. He mostly does it for scare. What he does is way worse. Yesterday, at my apartment, Rocco makes a weekly visit to every floor, to show owners a thing or two about handling their pets. My friend Leon ate two pieces of candy off the floor during his visit.
And he caught him?
Of course he did.
Was Leighton okay?
After being thrown out of the window, he wasn't all right. At least he still survived.
You might have not have heard this, but Rocco used to be in the Pussycat Olympics. One of his well-known specialties is the tail throw.
So, he does this all the time?
It's way better than being put in a chokey.
A chokey?
Yeah.
Hold on just a minute. What's a chokey?
Well, it's a small hole behind the shape of a cat door. You have to stand or sit in the disgusting, dripping pipes with jagged edges, and even the walls on the door have broken glass and nails sticking out of there.
Get inside, you festering bowl of pus.
Wait, he puts kittens in there?
Yeah. I've been in there twice. Sometimes, he can leave you in there, all day.
Did you tell your parents about it?
They didn't believe us.
I mean, would yours believe it?
Maybe. It all depends.
Get out of my way.
Here he comes.
Fresh meat. Well. Lilia.
What is it, Rocco?
What are those?
What's what?
Those things on your ears.
You mean, my flowers?
Do I allow flowers in this play place?
My mommy thinks those things are sweet.
Well, your mommy is a twit. The next time I see you, I want those flowers gone and off your ears.
But I don't.
But? Did you just say but?
Here comes the tail throw part.
Definitely.
I can't look.
I'll give you but.
Crazy Legs. Catch her.
Don't worry, I got you.
Oh, thank you. You saved my life.
Hooray!
Quiet. Now run along and scram before I throw you all into the chokey.
I gotta tell you, Crazy Legs, that was the best catch you've ever done.
Aw, thank you, buddy.
No problem.
Oh, by the way, guys, I believe I hear my mom calling. I gotta get inside. Later.
Later, Tundra.
So, what did you think of Kitty Cat Play?
My, it was amazing.
Agreed.
Minus the Rocco part.
So, what do you want to do tomorrow?
Do you think we could go and get some beverages?
That's not a bad idea, Crazy.
I could go with that.
And maybe we could go over to Tundra's.
That's a good choice. Well, I'm getting tired. I have to go to the second floor where my family is.
Yeah, I have to get back home too.
Crazy, I'm getting tired, too.
Yeah, so am I. I better get to bed. Good night, you too.
Good night, Crazy Legs.
Come on, Tina, let's get to bed.
Good night, Banjo.
Good night, Brinley. Oh, my gosh. Brinley is the most beautiful kitten I ever met before. Hey.
Hi, Banjo. Did you enjoy the play place?
Yeah, it was amazing. I've met some new friends there.
Great. Glad to hear it. Who took you there?
Crazy Legs did.
Wow. He must have made you very happy. By the way, it's getting late, so you better get to bed.
Yes, Mom.
Good night, Banjo. Sweet dreams.
Banjo.
Yeah?
Where are you going?
I'm going to see Crazy Legs. He's on the third floor.
Okay.
Good morning, Crazy Legs.
Well, good morning, Banjo, my buddy. You've come just in time.
In time for what?
Remember what we talked about last night?
Oh yeah. Going to the cafe to get some beverages and a few cookies.
You got it. Let's boogie on down.
You said it.
So, what is the cafe called?
Oh, I've been there many times before. The place is called Hogan's.
Yay.
That's actually pretty cool. Brinley and Tundra said they would meet up there.
There you guys are.
Hi, Brinley. Hi, Tundra.
Hi, Banjo. So, there's something about Rocco.
Really? Well, tell me about it.
So, you see, remember what happened at the play place yesterday?
Of course. I saw the whole thing.
So, Rocco came over to one of my friends, which was Lilia, and confronted her about those flowers she was wearing. She was very scared, and probably her feelings were hurt when Rocco told her that her mom was a twit. Then he grabbed her by the tail, spun her round and threw her. Luckily, thanks to Crazy Legs, she was safe.
So, Rocco must be really strong, huh?
Yeah. Darlin and Daniel told us everything about Rocco's scary behavior towards kittens, including us.
Yeah. So, anyways, what are you two getting from Hogan's? I'm getting a few cookies.
I'm getting the same thing too.
And do you want some milk to dig them in?
Sure. Tundra, that's Silver Cat. He's got a taser.
He's got a taser.
Tundra, are you all right?
Yeah.
Wow, crazy. I can't believe you did that.
I think you saved my life.
Aw, thank you. Oh, right. The refreshments.
Wow, these are delicious.
I would agree with you too.
I got to tell you, crazy. I really do love this place.
So do I, Tina.
Minus the incident.
So, Tundra, do you remember about what we were going to do next after this?
Of course. Heading over to my house.
Sweet. We should finish up our cookies before we go there.
Right.
So, Tundra, what do your parents look like?
Well, my mom is a Persian cat, and my dad is a Siamese.
Cool. I can't wait to meet them.
I've met them before.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Oh, Tundra, my girl. I'm glad to see you.
Thank goodness you're safe.
Oh, and I see you've brought some friends. What's your name, little orange kitty?
My name's Banjo. That other white kitten is Brinley, and that cat with the scarf and hat is Crazy Legs. And don't forget that white mouse, her name's Dina.
It's a real pleasure to meet you both.
Thank you. My name's Basin.
And I'm Frizzell. We all heard what happened at Hogan's.
Yes. As I've tried to tell you, there was an attempted robbery today.
Oh my heavens. Was anyone hurt?
Luckily, no one was. How did you both hear about it?
We heard it on the radio.
Could you explain to us how it all happened?
Well, we were all waiting in line at the counter, when I noticed a silver-furred cat with a taser. I warned Tundra, but Crazy Legs saw a different cat reaching for something, and thought he was the culprit. And that's when he grabbed Tundra and held her in front of him like a human shield. But as he did that, he accidentally knocked his beverage onto the actual culprit, burning his paw, causing him to drop his weapon and run out.
And no one else saw that happen?
Unfortunately not.
Wow, Crazy. I can't believe it. You really did save my daughter.
Why didn't you say anything?
Well, I was really relieved everyone was okay. I suppose it did irk me when everyone was praising me, and even the owner promised me a lifetime supply of cookies. Well, I'd never even thought this would go far, and come to think of it, I never even thought I'd hear it on the radio.
I wonder how much that would cost, a lifetime supply of cookies?
I don't know either, Tina.
By the way, Mom, is it alright if we head down to Kitty Cat Play?
Of course. Whatever you think is best.
Thanks, Mom.
So, do you think Rocco isn't gonna harm us?
I hope not.
What do you think he's gonna do?
I don't know. But we're gonna find out. At least Draco hasn't popped up yet.
Yep. So far, everything's alright.
Should we go play on the kitty slide?
Yeah. Let's go. After you.
Hop to it. All of you kittens will report to my stage hall. Sit.
What's going on?
Beats me.
Scrawny. Would little Scrawny come up here, please?
Uh-oh. He lives on my block.
This little brown man called Kitty, Scrawny, is none other than a vicious sneak thief. You're a sickening and disgusting criminal, aren't you?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
My dessert. Cake. Cheesecake. You snuck into the kitchen like a little mouse and ate my personal snack. Do you deny it? Confess.
Well, it's kind of tricky for me to remember a specific kind of cake.
Well, this one was mine. And it was the most delicious cheesecake I ever had in the entire world.
My owner's one is better.
It is it? How can you be sure unless you have another piece? Sit down, Scrawny. Here we go. Smells like cream cheese, doesn't it? Now, eat it.
I don't want any, thank you.
Eat it. Wow. You look like you enjoyed that, Scrawny.
Yes, sir.
You must have some more.
Oh, no, thank you.
But you'll hurt my assistant's feelings.
Huh.
Itchy. He made this cheesecake just for you, to have on your very own. His sweat and blood went into this dessert, and you'll not leave this stage until you have consumed the whole entire confection.
Whole entire confection. See you later.
Thank you, Itchy. Now, you've won a cheesecake, now you've got it. Now, eat it.
He's gonna throw up.
I can't look.
Is he gonna throw up?
Without a doubt.
Scrawny looks real bad.
Give up.
You can do it, Scrawny. You can do it.
Yeah, you can do it.
Scrawny, 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 Scrawny.
Scrawny, 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 silence.
Scrawny, 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 Scrawny.
Stop.
Scrawny,
silence.
Scrawny, 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 Scrawny.
Yeah.
Shut up. All of you kittens will stay 5 hours in here and think about what you did. If any of you kittens refuse or leave before the 5 hours is up, you will go straight into the chokey. Together.
Hey kid, I'm really sorry about what Rocco has done.
Hopefully, if anything bad happens to you at the play place tomorrow, I'll deal with it.
Okay. I got it.
See you tomorrow.
You too.
Banjo, where were you all night? Well, it's 11 p.m., kiddo. Your bedtime was 2 hours ago.
Honey, please calm down. Banjo, can you tell me what caused you to stay up late?
Okay. Well, a big brown cat named Rocco kept us all late because this one kitten ate some cheesecake.
Really?
Yeah, it's true.
Oh dear. Were you okay?
Yes, Mom.
What's going on, Mommy?
Banjo came home late.
Is he all right?
Of course he is.
That's a relief.
All right, kiddo, let's get to bed. It's late.
Young lady, where were you?
Rocco kept all of us at the play place late because this Maine Coon kitten ate some cheesecake.
That's the biggest lie I've ever heard in my life. You see all of this junk mail? They were all left out because you weren't even there to take them in.
Well, I don't think it's fair.
What?
Our owner gets all of this mail from catalogs, and I don't even get anything.
But come on, sweetie, it's not catalogs. It's all pet stuff.
Oh, if you think it's all pet stuff, why doesn't he have it sent to the shelter?
Because the animal control might be watching the shelter.
There's animal control outside watching the house.
What?
They're parked outside right now.
Brinley, you're such an ignoramus. Those guys are dogs.
AC officers.
Dogs? I don't see any out there.
Well, some people like to play with those. Some have fun with cats, and some have fun with dogs.
And some people are animal control.
Are not.
Are too.
Are not. I want to know if those stray catchers or animal control are watching us. Now get to bed, you lying little rug muffin.
Ugh. Yes, Dad.
Hey, Whitey. Have a marshmallow.
I think I found the ladybug.
Really?
Let's see it. Wow, that looks cool. Let's show it to the others.
Ooh. It looks pretty. Look at all the pretty red colors. And the black dots. Don't you just love to look at these? Yes, Walnut. Nature is always just absolutely beautiful.
How could you keep going?
Useless. Flaming. Car. Banjo. Sell me a lemon. You're heading straight for the Chokey, young man.
Chokey?
To teach you a lesson.
What lesson?
You and Crazy Legs think you can make a fool out of me.
Crazy Legs?
The cat with that stupid scarf.
I'm nothing like him.
You're the second image. The apple never rots far from the tree.
Crazy Legs.
Not right now. Rocco is coming out right now to talk to all of us. Make sure to be quiet as he talks. Kittens, hide everything that Rocco dislikes or hates. Put away everything colorful. And take off any flowers, especially you, Lilia. I hear him coming.
Don't breathe at all either.
Hey, Rocco.
Hey, Rocco.
Shoo. I've never been able to understand why these small little kittens are so sickening and disgusting. They're the haunts of my life. They're also like little mice. They should be gotten rid of as early as possible. My idea of a perfect little play place is one in which there are no little kittens. At all. Do you agree, Crazy Legs? Now you, look at me.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
The next time I tell you to bring me something, you'll do it faster, won't you?
Yes, Rocco.
Crazy, this might be the most interesting thing you've ever done.
Go sit down, you squirming worm of vomit. Get up. Can you spell a word for me?
Well, Crazy Legs taught us how to spell a long word one time.
And what word is that?
We can spell the word, difficulty.
Oh, you couldn't spell difficulty if your life depended on it.
Well, he taught us how to spell it with a poem.
Ooh, a poem. How sweet. And what poem would that be?
Okay, here we go. Mrs. D, Mrs. I.
Mrs. F, F, I, Mrs. C, Mrs. U, Mrs. L, T, Y.
Why are all these women married, Mrs. D, Mrs. I? This is supposed to be spelling, not poetry. I can't for the life of me understand why these small little kittens take so long to grow up. I think they all do it deliberately just to annoy me. Huh? What's so funny? Come on! Spit it out. Speak up. I like a joke as well as the next fat cat. Ah. It's an ant. It's an ant. It's an ant. One of you tried to poison me. Who? Oh. Bando. I knew it.
I just want to clarify that's not an ant. It's a ladybug.
What did you say?
It's a ladybug, Rocco.
Stand up, you villainous sack of chicken poop. You did this.
No, I didn't, Rocco.
Did you act alone? Or did you have any accomplices?
I didn't do it.
You didn't like the chokey, did you? You think you could pay me back, huh? Well, I'll pay you back, young man.
For what? Rocco?
For this stinking ladybug, you piss worm.
I'm telling you, I didn't do it.
Besides, even if you didn't do it, I'm gonna punish you, because I'm a big cat, and you're a small kitten. I'm right, you're wrong. And there's nothing you can do about it. You're a total liar, and a scoundrel, and Crazy Legs is too a liar and a cheater. You're one of the most corrupt animals in the history of this place. Am I wrong? Oh, I'm never wrong. In this play place, in this city, in this state, I am God. Get it off, get it off.
I didn't even move.
You did this.
Hey. How could he possibly do it when he was just sitting here the whole time?
I'll be watching you little kitties. Each and every one of you. When you head over to this play place, when you chase around, anything playful, I'll be watching you. Every single one of you. And especially, you.
Hey Banjo, thanks for not telling.
No problem. Best friends don't tell.
That was a close one, Crazy.
It sure was.
I mean, Rocco is the worst cat in Salt Lake City.
Definitely.
Banjo, is there anything we can do?
Let me handle this one.
Okay, Brinley.
Banjo?
Yes, Brinley.
I was wondering, do you think we could go for a walk together through the city? Just you and I.
I think that's a good idea. It can help us spend some time away from Rocco's scary behavior.
Yeah. Same here. Rocco is such a mean and evil cat who doesn't like kittens, especially us. I bet all cats fear him.
Yeah, I thought so too. Hey Crazy, do you think we could go for a walk now?
Sure you can. I'll make sure your parents know about it.
Alright. We'll see you later.
See you as well. Have a good time out.
So Banjo, what's it like back down in Payson?
Well, at the farm, one of the things I like to do is chase chickens.
That's actually pretty cool. The thing I like to chase is squirrels.
That's pretty amazing. Seems to me we both like chasing stuff.
Yeah.
The only problem is, my dad doesn't like it.
So does mine.
Hey, that cloud looks like a chicken.
I think so, too. The thing you like chasing. Hey Banjo, this one looks like a squirrel.
Hey, you're right. It does look like one.
Aw, isn't it nice watching the clouds here?
Yeah, it sure does. Uh-oh, that's not good.
When the clouds turn gray, that means... rain.
Follow me, Brinley. I know a place where to wait out the storm.
All right. I'm right behind you.
Quick. And here.
So, this is where you went in?
Yeah. I couldn't find a box or a discarded umbrella.
You must not like getting wet. I don't like it either. So, what else happened when you lied down inside?
It got me to thinking.
Like what? Did you start feeling homesick?
You could say that.
Okay, what else was there?
I looked down at my own reflection, and in there. I saw my family reflected in there.
Wow. Really?
Uh-huh. I saw my mom, then my dad, then my two little sisters, Emily and Jean. Was your family sort of like mine?
I wish.
Mommy. Banjo's chasing chickens again.
You have exactly 1 minute to fetch me a switch.
The apple never rots far from the tree.
What did I tell you about upsetting the chickens?
Hey Dipface, here's your ball of yarn.
Do not upset them.
Banjo, are you okay? What's the matter? You can tell me anything you want. I won't get mad, because I love you.
Why is it that big cats are scary and mean?
Well, not all of them are. You see, you and Crazy Legs are very close friends, just like how me and Tundra are. Look, no family is perfect. But, yours is the best you can get, so what is it that made you feel sad like this?
Well, back over in Payson, I jumped off the roof of the chicken coop with my sisters, and my dad was not very happy.
Oh dear. What did he say?
He told me that I had exactly a minute to fetch him a switch. Do you even know what he means by that?
As a matter of fact, I do. What he means is that basically, he told you to get a stick so he could spank your little bottom.
That explains it. Why did he make me do that? I just landed on my feet when I jumped off that roof. I don't like getting punished.
You could have just jumped off a log or at least a fence post. Aw, there, Banjo. I feel really sorry about what your dad did. I'm sure it won't happen ever again. Please don't cry. I really love you.
Bah, Brinley? We're not old enough to be married.
I know. What usually calms you down when you're crying?
Well, my mom always made me feel better. And at night, she would sing a sweet lullaby to me before I went to sleep. She would wrap her arms and paws around me, keeping me safe and warm. Does your mom sing a lullaby to you?
Well, she used to. I've listened to Tundra's one too.
Used to? You mean?
When I was born, my mother sang this to me because I had trouble falling asleep. It was also used to overcome my fears.
Brinley, when the storm passes, do you think we could meet up with Crazy Legs and Tina?
Sure. Now, this song is one of my favorites. I think you're the most handsome kitten I've ever met before. You have nice orange fur, like the fields out in Payson. It makes me think of your true colors.
Ah, you really think so?
Huh? Now, here I go.
Discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all, and the darkness inside you makes you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you so. Crazy, and you've taken all you can. You call me up because you know I'll be there, and I see.
Wow, Brimley, this is amazing. I love to look at these. As you said before, it does make me think of my true colors.
Ah, so do I. It makes me think of my true colors too.
Gee, crazy. Do you think Banjo will ever come back? He and Brinley have been gone for quite a while.
Don't worry, Tina. They'll be back. There you two are. How did everything go?
Oh, it went excellent.
We looked up at a rainbow.
That's amazing. I actually saw the same rainbow from over there.
So did I.
So, is there anything we can try to find out more about Rocco?
As a matter of fact, There is. You want to come over to my place and talk about it?
We'd like that very much.
Good idea. That's where Rocco lives.
Hey, why do I see some old abandoned toys?
Someone I know used to live in that house. I had an owner who was very kind to me, as well as both dogs and cats alike. He was a violinist and also worked for an orchestra. When I was a kitten, his wife died in a tragic car accident.
Oh dear.
What was your owner's name?
His name was Leopold Wood. After his wife died, he needed someone to look after things at home, and he adopted a brown cat to come and live with them. But he was a mean and ill-tempered cat who treated me very badly.
Rocco.
Yes. And the worst part of all, when I got older, Leopold died.
How did he die?
He got shot during World War II.
How'd that happen?
I can't remember, but the ending is more happy. I found a nice apartment after one of Leopold's close relatives purchased it for $6,000, and I moved out of the wicked cat's house, and I was finally free.
Wow, that's a pretty amazing story. No way. That brown cat you mentioned was indeed Rocco.
Yes. It was Rocco. When I left my owner's house, I had to leave all of my precious and lovely things behind.
Really?
What kind of things did you have to leave?
Photographs of Leopold and his wife, and a mouse toy his wife gave to me. I named the mouse Tina.
Hey, when you first saw me, you named me after that toy. That's pretty amazing.
Yes, it is.
I thought big cats weren't scared of anything.
Not necessarily. All cats get scared, just like kittens like you too.
I wonder what Rocco's scared of. There he is.
What is he doing?
It looks like he's putting weights into the trunk of his vehicle.
How will we get in?
We have to wait until he leaves.
Where do you think he's going, crazy?
Seems to me he's gonna head down for the Pussycat Olympics, judging by that medal he's wearing.
Well, he must have won a lot.
Rocco's scared of mice?
Brown ones, especially. He gets very superstitious of them.
Oh dear, you're a little mousy.
Don't worry, Tina, he's all right.
Hopefully.
Let's go in and get your precious stuff.
No, not yet, Banjo.
Why not? He's gone.
Brinley and Tundra need to make sure the coast is clear enough.
I think the coast is clear.
You may head on in. If Rocco gets back, we'll go find another place to hide, and if you're still inside, it's best to split up and hide. Try distracting him if that's what's best.
All right. Come on, crazy.
Wait for me.
Come on, move, you piece of junkyard fodder. Come on, Shifty. Are you kidding me? I'm almost out of gas.
Oh, my. Goodness. My owner's portrait used to hang up there.
Whoever made that painting of Rocco must have had a big stomach. A gigantic and strong one.
I think we should go. It's my box of cat treats.
Really?
Yes, Banjo. Every night, after dinner, Leopold would give me two or three pieces of these cat treats. After he died, Rocco had counted them, so I couldn't even sneak one. or two, or three. He'd take a piece, put it in his mouth, and say,
"Much too good for kittens."
You should have one.
Oh, no. He'd notice.
Where's your mousy doll?
Upstairs. Come on, Banjo. Wait for me.
Hug, 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 hug. You filthy. Crush the little weasel.
This was my room. That's my owner.
What was his name again?
Leopold Wood. I used to call him Leo, and he called me crazy for short.
I still don't know how Leopold got shot.
Neither do I.
Hey, is that your doll over there?
Why, yes it is.
Crazy legs. You useless cat with a stupid scarf. I want a new car. And I already know what this whole caveat empty means, you no good, low-life liar. I'm gonna find you, I'm gonna burn down your showroom, and I'm even gonna take that no good lemon you gave me and shove it right up your bazinga. When I'm finished with you, you're gonna look like roadkill.
Shouldn't we go hide or something?
Yes. Remember what Tundra said. Go to the end of the hall, downstairs, and out through the kitchen door. I'll distract him.
Who's in my house? Come out and fight like a man.
Let's go. Come on.
Some rats are gonna die today.
Hey Brinley, feel my heart. Weren't you the most scared you've ever been?
Yeah, it really was. We better go.
He should not be allowed to treat kittens like that.
Especially me.
Yeah, someone's gotta teach him a lesson.
Wait until he leaves again, and then we might go get that doll. Well, maybe.
But I must warn you, Banjo. Promise me you'll never go back in that house again, right?
Yes, Crazy. I promise.
All right, let's get going.
Hello?
Hey Itchy, this is Rocco.
Oh hey Rocco. What's going on?
Well, you're not gonna believe this, but I think someone came to my house.
Oh my gosh. Who was it?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find out. Bring my henchmen over to my house for a discussion meeting.
Yes, sir. I'll go get Ricky, Boris, Tyron, Willie, Zion, and VJ over. See you in a bit.
You too. Bye.
Gosh, I really hate Rocco.
So do I, Banjo. I can't let that big bad brown cat hurting any more kittens.
To be honest with you, I don't want him causing any more harm either.
Neither do I, Tina.
What are we gonna do?
Yeah. There's gotta be something.
Crazy, do you know who might help us?
I think I might know who could help us.
And who could that be?
Zazu.
Zazu? Oh my, I remember her.
Sugar baby, can't
you see? I'm all dressed up in Saturday night dance. Call my boogie boogie sugar baby out tonight. Call my boogie boogie sugar baby out tonight. Banjo, Brinley, and Tundra. This is Cleo. Marina. Ali. And Zazu. Ali's also the gold one and she's the newest member.
My goodness. What precious little ones we've got here. Hey Crazy, what brings these kittens here?
Well, I've been playing with them back over at Kitty Cat Play.
Yeah, we did. By the way Zazu, this is Brinley, and this is Tundra.
Hello cat sisters.
It's a really great pleasure to meet you four.
Thank you. We are the cat sisters. My name's Zazu.
I'm Marina.
I'm Cleo.
And I'm Molly.
Ali's the newest member.
I gotta tell you, Ali, you're a spunky cat.
Oh, thank you, Banjo.
You're welcome.
So, last time we saw you, you ran away from home and you missed your family, is that correct?
Ah, indeed it was.
So what is it that's going on this time?
Well, there's this one big cat who's been scaring and hurting kittens like us.
He has brown fur, he likes cheesecake, and he doesn't even like kittens.
And he even used to be in the Pussycat Olympics.
I think I might know who you're referring to, aren't you?
Yes.
You must be referring to Rocco. All cats fear him, including kittens.
I got to admit, sis, I don't like that big brown cat.
Me neither.
Neither do I. He's pretty creepy.
That's exactly the point, you girls.
Now, if we're gonna defeat Rocco, there's one thing we gotta do. And that thing we gotta do is...
I know this one. Stick together.
You got it. I'll stick with you, kid. And you stick with me. And together, we'll overcome adversity. And old man Trouble, well, he'll have to let you be. Because you're gonna come out smiling, if you stick with me.
So keep your chin up and look up high. You'll find your trouble will pass you by. I'll stick with you, kid, you stick with me. Together we'll overcome adversity. Old man Trouble will have to let you be. Cause you're gonna come out smiling if you stick with me.
Cause safety in numbers, we always work things out. We can't be too careful, there's danger all about. So look in each corner and under bushes too. There could be a growling thing that's waiting there for you.
Oh no, crazy. What do I do?
What do you do? Well, I'll stick with you, kid. You stick with me. Together we'll overcome adversity. And old man Trouble will have to let you be. Cause you're gonna come out smiling if you stick with me.
Subject is eating, that's what it's all about.
A chicken, a tuna, and now and then a trout.
Ain't got the chicken,
and tuna can't be found.
The truth is, we're starving, there ain't no food in town.
Oh no, what will I do?
What do you do? Well,
I'll stick with you, kid, you stick with me.
Together we'll overcome it.
And old man Trouble will have to let you be. Cause you're gonna come out smiling if you stick with me.
All right, all you cats, we need to come up with a plan to stop Rocco and get him out of this city for good. Will you all help us? All right. Let's cover the whole town. So get back to your own neighborhoods and start planning.
You're gonna come out smiling.
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 You're gonna come out smiling if you stay.
Thank you all. Now, if we want to defeat Rocco and his henchmen, there's one thing we gotta do.
We use it many times.
It's our number one power.
And our number one specialty.
And that specialty is...
Go Power.
Throw your hands up.
Before, but I know I'm not perfect.
Wow, that was excellent.
All right, everyone. Go on out and start planning. Okay, guys, if we want to defeat Rocco and kick him out of the city, the first step is that we have to try to scare him.
Yay. We gotta scare the living daylights out of that creepy big brown monster.
Indeed we do, Tina. Do you have any suggestions and ideas? Let's start with you, Chandra.
Well, I was thinking we could try to lock him inside one of the rooms in his house.
That is quite possible, but probably not clever. What about you, Brinley?
Maybe a series of pranks?
Oh, I know.
Really? What is your idea, Banjo?
How about we set up pranks and booby traps around his house into thinking he and his troops are being haunted by the ghost of your owner, Leopold?
That's an excellent idea.
What's going on? Did I hear something about pranks?
Why, yes, you two have. What are your names?
My name's Emily. And I'm Jean.
Crazy, those two are my little sisters. Emily, Jean, this is Brinley, and this is Tundra.
Hi there, you two.
You want to know what has been going on?
Well, what is it that's happening? We heard your conversation downstairs.
Well, a few days ago, Crazy Legs took me to this fun playground for kittens. The name of the place is called Kitty Cat Play. On the way there, I met Brinley for the first time, and when I got to the playground, I met Tundra. But then this big brown cat comes out and I got scared. Then two kittens named Darlene and Danielle came to us and told us all about him. His name is Rocco, and he's been scaring and abusing kittens. And from what Zazu and the cat sisters told me, all cats fear him.
Oh my goodness. What did he do that made him that scary?
Well, he forced one kitten to eat a whole cheesecake after supposedly eating his. He grabbed one kitten by her tail and threw her. But then Crazy Legs saved her. And even worse, he put me in the chokey.
No way. Were you okay, big brother?
Thankfully, I was. Crazy Legs rescued me out. Me and Brinley then spent some time together away from Rocco's scary behavior. We looked up at a rainbow as we thought of our true colors.
That is much more happy. So anyways, what are all of you planning on?
Why, we're forming a plan to try to get Rocco out of the city so that he doesn't hurt us anymore. The first step in the process is we have to try to scare him. Your big brother Banjo came up with a great idea, which is setting up pranks and booby traps.
That's the most amazing idea you've come up with, big brother.
Aw, thank you, my little sisters. I love you both so much.
So, how are we going to set up these traps?
Well, my idea is to make it look like Rocco and his troops are getting haunted by the ghost of Crazy's late owner, Leopold Wood. Do you both have any booby trap ideas?
Whoopee cushions, water balloons, clock striking, spooky ghost sounds, spraying sink, wind blowing, flying objects, firecrackers.
Okay. That's enough ideas. Now, we need to get supplies to set up the traps. Hey Crazy, do you have any stuff?
I've got some whoopee cushions.
I've got water balloons.
Excellent. Now, I wonder if Darlene and Danielle have some more for the other traps.
Should we go see them?
Might as well.
Hello there. What can I help you kitties with?
I was wondering if you two have any stuff we need for pranks.
We're trying to scare off Rocco and his henchmen with pranks and booby traps to make it look like he's getting haunted by a ghost.
The ghost of Crazy Legs' owner, Leopold Wood.
As a matter of fact, we do.
Cool. What stuff do you two have?
Right this way. We've got so much stuff.
Alright. Wow. That's a lot of stuff in there.
What kind of stuff is that?
My little sisters here gave us a lot of booby trap ideas. So far, Crazy Legs said that he has whoopee cushions, and Tina said she's got water balloons.
I've got firecrackers. I've got a bucket of tar. Don't worry. It's not hot. And I've got some sticky maple syrup too. These are just about the right kind of stuff you can use to make Rocco's house look haunted. By the way, who's going to set up the traps?
Well, since Crazy Legs promised me not to go back into Rocco's house, I'm gonna let my little sisters set them up. Does that sound okay to you too?
Sure.
Alright. Good luck you two. And do it real quiet and quickly before Rocco and his henchmen come inside.
Okay, we got it. Alright, sisters, quietly go into the house and set up all the traps as you can. But make it quick before Rocco and his henchmen get here. Also, try to get Crazy's little mousy doll.
You got it. We've got your back, big brother. That must be Crazy Legs' mousy doll. Okay, we got the traps set up.
Way to go.
And also, we got this along the way.
Nice work. You got the mousy doll. Crazy Legs is gonna be really happy. Now, let's go hide so we can see Rocco and his henchman's reaction.
Yes, big brother.
You freaking little junkyard piece of trash.
Rocco, calm down. Yelling isn't going to help your case.
Itchy, I have no freaking idea why my car is making those noises. I just put a fresh tank of gas in there. Anyways, all of you come inside for my meeting. Alright boys, you want to know what this discussion meeting is about?
Something about kittens, correct?
I'm almost speechless, sir.
Oh, you don't have to be.
Sorry.
Anyways, earlier today, I saw what appears to be two cats in my house.
Which two cats were in there?
The last time I remembered, one of them was a big cat and the other was a little kitten.
How did they manage to enter your house?
Well, they instead snuck in while I was out. My car then ran out of gas and then I drove back to my house. I then began calling Crazy Legs, threatening him. And that's when I noticed the lid on the box of cat treats. I sniffed it, noticing that someone was in there.
What did you do while you were looking for them?
I got distracted by many sounds that I almost gave up and went into the kitchen and had myself a slice of cheesecake.
What else happened?
After I heard the door closing, I immediately stopped and ran to see who did it. I then followed who was in the basement, breaking the chains with my bare paws, and ran out to see who was there. Much to my fury, I didn't see anyone, and I stormed immediately back inside and called up Itchy about it.
You got that right.
You owe me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta go wash my paws.
What's going on with Rocco?
I don't know.
You.
What's the matter, Ricky?
Ugh. Spider. I hate spiders.
I better go get a paper towel and wipe your feet off, Ricky. Ugh. What is all this?
Ouch. 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 Ouch.
What in tarnation is going on in here?
Someone set up all these traps in here.
Thank you.
Rocco, I'm scared. What's going on?
I don't know, Itchy. But it sure ain't pretty. Guys, look what I found.
What is it, Rocco?
I found this little piece of cat hair on the ground. I think I might know who entered my house.
Wow, good work.
One question, how are we going to catch whoever came in?
Should we build some traps around the city?
Actually, yes, you guys should. Tomorrow, we will start building the traps, and then when we get to Kitty Cat Play, we'll get that little rascal to admit his guilt and then catch him. You all got that?
Yes, sir.
Hug, hug, hug.
I'll get some bait.
Rocco.
What?
Whoa. Behold, a super duper extra duper hacka kitty trap.
Ugh, I'm scared of heights.
Oh, what do you know? It even captures Willy too.
I'd like to see a kitten or cat try and breach these defenses.
It's impressive, Rocco.
Now, to await the attack.
Crazy legs. You'll never believe what my sister's got you.
Oh, what is it? Aw. It's my little mousy doll. Thank you so much, kid.
No problem.
What an excellent plan you did.
Well, Crazy, in a few minutes, I will be teaching the kitties a lesson today.
He is really ill-tempered and raving mad.
And what is it your owner used to call you again?
Crazy. I'm pretty sure he knows my mousy doll is missing.
And he called him Rocco?
Of course he did. Maybe I could go back over to my place and put the doll back, but not yet.
Stay calm, Crazy. It's gonna be alright.
I know, Tina. And Banjo, you promised me not to go back into the house again, right?
I promised. I stayed outside the whole time. My sisters went in to set up the pranks and booby traps.
Well, that went well.
All of you, out here. Quickly. Run, run, run. Milk. And hold the ladybugs. Join the others. Move. I'm here to teach all of you kitties a lesson. Sometimes in life, strange, horrible, pathetic, and unexplainable things happen. These things are all a test of character. And I have character. All of you form a line across the field. Quickly. Run, run, run. Don't even keep me waiting. Fill the gap. Now then, I expect you're all wondering what I'm talking about today, huh? That's right. A kitten came to my house. I don't know how, I don't know when, and I don't know why.
Rocco, may I?
Absolutely not. But I know a kitten came. And do you know that it's illegal to enter other people's homes without their permission?
Yes, Rocco, sir.
Stand up straight. Stand still. Still, still, still. Now then, do any of you recognize this? Let's all play a little game, shall we? Whose cat hair is colored orange? Can you answer me that? Who does this disgusting cat hair belong to? I shall personally see to it. That the demented, looking, fish-breathed little ragamuffin who owns this disgusting tuft of cat hair will never, ever see the light of day again. You.
Rocco, I was the one who was at your house last night. I can explain everything.
I broke your arm once before, and I can do it again, crazy.
I am not a little kitten anymore, Rocco.
Shut your muzzles. You will be put away in a place where not even the crows can land their droppings on you. Noise, get him.
Yes, sir.
You can run, but you can't hide.
Banjo.
Banjo.
Wait. Don't go.
Banjo.
Banjo.
Please come back.
Maybe he went this way. Huh? Banjo?
You said Rocco wouldn't get me. You promised.
Banjo, we're so sorry.
This is all Rocco's fault.
It's all right.
Don't worry, Banjo. We're gonna get you out of there.
Banjo.
Aw, thank you so much for freeing me out.
No problem.
Rocco. Rocco. You've got to listen to me. This is very urgent.
What is it now, Itchy?
Well, you're not gonna believe what I saw. Those two white kittens freed out that little orange kitty.
get him out of one of our traps? This can't be. Now you listen here, Ichi. If you see that little orange kitten, go get me a switch so I can spank his little bottom.
But sir, didn't his dad tell him that before?
I don't wanna hear, but out of your mouth. I'm giving you this one thing to do. If you see the disgusting little orange ragamuffin thing, go get me a switch.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Get it right this time.
Guys, you won't believe what just happened.
Well, what did that big brown beanie do this time?
One of his bad boys trapped me in one of their traps.
What? Is this some kind of joke?
No, it isn't, Danielle.
After Rocco thought that Banjo was the one who came into his house last night, Banjo ran away from him into the woods.
After he got trapped, we apologized to him and luckily, I saw the rope on top of the cage, and I freed him out.
Yeah, I can thank Tundra on that part.
You did a really wonderful job freeing Banjo out, Tundra.
Thanks, Lilia.
What was it that made Rocco think that it was you who entered his house?
I don't know how he thought. It might have been from the booby traps.
Did he really think you did it?
Possibly, but I didn't even go inside. It was my little sisters Emily and Jean that went in there.
Well, in that case, we need to think of a way to get Rocco out of here once and for all.
Yeah, including those henchmen he has.
Any ideas, anyone?
I've got one. What is it, Walnut? How about we make his henchmen go into a room filled with a bunch of booby traps near this play place? Then, after Rocco gets beaten, we can all throw a bunch of cat toys at him as he gets hauled into the animal control van. Does that sound like a good plan, you two?
Yeah, I would definitely agree with you, Walnut.
I'm with Darlene on this one. Yeah, count me in.
Me too.
So do I.
Same. What about you, Banjo?
That sounds absolutely excellent. Let's give them what they deserve. And we'll get Zazu and the Cat Sisters in here to help out as well.
Now!
Guys, do something.
Up here, you scurvy scum.
Go power.
What in the world? Where did my assistants go? They must have gotten scared away by those kittens.
Well, 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 Itchy. Did you get me a switch yet?
No, sir.
Why didn't you? I told you to go fetch me one, but you didn't. Why?
I just noticed that our assistants, Ricky, Boris, Tyron, Willie, Zion, and VJ have went missing. Do you have any possibility behind this?
Well, if it was those kittens that set up a bunch of booby traps in the room, we are so gonna get them. And I bet that little orange troublemaker is the one responsible for all of this.
Let's go find them.
Well, great job. We finally pranked those bad guys. Now all we have left is Rocco.
I knew we could do this.
Me too.
Excellent work, kitties.
That is the first step to getting rid of Rocco.
We'd still got to think of some way to defeat him. Oh, hi Mom, Dad, Emily and Jean.
Well, hello Banjo. We've been curious about what has been going on over the past few days.
Would you like to explain what has been happening?
Sure. Oh, and by the way, this is Crazy Legs. And this is Tina.
Hello, parents of Banjo. The name's Crazy Legs.
And my name's Tina.
It's good to meet you, Mr. Legs. I'm his father.
I'm his mother.
Now. The things that have been happening over the past few days is the scary big brown cat that has been scaring other kittens, especially me. His name's Rocco.
We've been told about his scary behavior before,
and all cats fear him.
What? Is this some kind of joke?
No, it's not, Dad. And the worst thing he did to me was that he locked me in that chokey.
Oh my goodness. Were you okay?
Thankfully, I was. Mr. Legs then freed me out of there.
Also, me and Jean also went into Rocco's house to set up pranks and traps to scare him.
It was my idea. I didn't go in, because Crazy promised me not to go back in there.
We're glad that you were all safe.
Anyways, what are the names of those two white kitties you got beside you?
Well, my name's Brinley.
And I'm Tundra. I've been very close friends with her.
Nice to meet you too. Anyways, where is this Rocco cat?
Does this answer your question?
Oh. So it is you, Rocco. How could you put our poor son in that checky?
He didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah. You should be ashamed.
Just you wait until we tell the AC.
Oh, you ain't telling those officers nothing.
Banjo, you've gotta do something.
Let me handle this. Banjo, I'm gonna give you this one thing to do.
And what's that?
You have exactly 1 minute to fetch me a switch.
What? You mean, you're not gonna spank me this time?
Nope. Not this time. I'm gonna spank both Rocco and Itchy to teach them a lesson.
Alright.
I can't find any switches.
Me neither.
Hey, I found one. Here you go, Banjo.
Thanks, Tundra. I'll go give this to my dad. Here you go, Dad.
Thank you. Now, Rocco, this is what you and Richie get.
There.
Don't you ever hurt my son again.
Now take this. That's what you also get for taking all my precious stuff.
Now, eat this.
You too,
Itchy.
We finally did it. Rocco's gone.
Never to be seen or heard from, and never to darken Salt Lake City again.
Well, Banjo, it is a great pleasure for me to visit your farm here.
It sure is. Everything is completely back to normal. Should we play a game of tag?
Well, I don't see why not. I would love to.
Alright. That sounds like a good idea.
Hey you. Hey, we're leaving. Come on, let's go. Get on the truck, hurry up.
I'd be happy to drive her home.
Well, no one's gonna be there. We're moving to Barbados.
Barbados?
Yeah. Our owner just got a new job down there.
I don't want to leave.
But we're going on a permanent vacation.
Yeah, our owner's gotta beat those bulldogs to the airport.
But I love it here. I love this farm, I love Payson, I love Salt Lake City, it's not fair. Banjo, please don't let them.
Get on the truck, Brinkley.
It's Brinley.
Whatever.
I want to stay with Banjo.
Look here, Banjo doesn't want you. Why would he want some ugly, disobedient kitten?
Because she's the most beautiful kitten I've ever met in my life. And I love her.
You can adopt me.
Listen here, I don't have time for all of these legalities.
Just a second, Dad. I think I have the adoption papers.
What? Hey, where did you find these?
Off of our owner's desk. He must have Xeroxed them.
Are you hearing this, David?
All you gotta do is sign them.
I'll be an only kitten again.
Shut up. I cannot even think with all of this chitter-chattering. What do you think, Peachy?
Oh, Brinley. You were our only little girl we've ever had in our family. And we, almost, never understood you. Not even a smidgen of a bit. Who's got a pen?
I do.
Your owner's not gonna be calling our owner for support payments or anything like that.
Oh, don't worry about that.
He will have everything we need.
All right, let's roll.
Brinley, I am so very happy you are now part of our family. I've never been like this before.
Me too, Banjo. I can't wait for how much amazing stuff we'll do together.
Hey, Banjo.
Oh, hey, Crazy. What is it that you and Teen want to tell us?
Well, Zazu and the rest of the Cat Sisters have a special surprise down for you down at their place. It's gonna be really good.
Really? Have we all been invited?
Yes, we have.
We better get going. We don't want to be late for this.
And now, please welcome the Cat Sisters. Zazu, Marina, Cleo, and Dali.
Thank you all for coming. Now, before we get started, we would like to give a huge thank you to our favorite woodpile cat, Banjo, for the defeat of Rocco. Now, this song goes out to him.
Banjo's a cat who could not behave. He seldom did what he should. Banjo was not really that big thing. It's just he couldn't be good. He had a net for a ruckus around, although he was tiny and small. A weapon for Mama and Papa.
Starting out on a journey, never dreaming what we'd have to go through. Now here we are, and I'm suddenly standing at the beginning with you.
No one told me I was going to find you. Unexpected what you did to my heart. When to remind me,
this is the start.
And life is a road and I wanna keep going. Love is a river I wanna keep flowing. Life is a road, now and forever. Wonderful journey. I'll be there when the world stops turning. I'll be there when the storm is through. In the end I wanna be standing at the beginning.
keep flowing on. Starting out on a journey.
Survive.